Well, I've been avoiding making this video all day, trying to do other stuff like corn syrup videos. And why? Because this one might sounds very outlandish, actually. So there's a tendency to say, why should I even do this video at all? It's like, uh-oh, this has gone too far, you know, going too far. Well, going too far is what we're all about, because who's defining too far? Who's defining too far? That's a good question, isn't it? Those who want to, quote-unquote, compromise, meaning break our momentum, that's going, they say, oh, you've gone too far now. Well, I have stated before that there's going to be turmoil in this world. In fact, there already is. It's already a bad situation in this world. In terms of breaking our spiritual momentum, it's a very bad thing. So, I've always believed that there will be a time in this world when we need to sidestep this world somehow. It's going to be way, way too manic in a negative way, manically persecuting spiritual momentum. So I've been thinking all my life, where are we going to go? Where are we going to go? And this is a big question. I had a dream where I was invited to go to the dwelling place of one that I believe was Jesus. And so we will see. I will have to, you know, see if there's corroborating evidence of that. And he said his home was nearby, very nearby. His dwelling place was very nearby. So I assume it is somewhere in the solar system. And since that time, I've started to get a whole bunch of information has been coming. And about Venus and ancient history, looking at ancient history. I used to study all this stuff, so I had to know somewhat about it, really. They say Sanat Kumara came from Venus with 144,000 volunteers to come to planet Earth and try to resurrect the us out of this horrible darkness of false belief that this planet had fallen into. There's a lot of information about Venus. It's a place of fourth dimensional Venusians, if we say Venusians, quite advanced in a lot of ways. It's fourth dimensional civilization, and then beyond that, there's a lot of spirituality connected with Venus, actually. And it's very close. And of course, we're able to have shuttles now where they're getting ready to send people into space, celebrities, rich people, maybe eventually visiting the moon. So if we can do this without where we're at, and the Venusians are fourth dimensional, way more advanced. They have transport through mental. They can produce light ships with their mind to transport them. So transporting us from this planet Earth to Venus would actually be a piece of cake for them. So today I just was talking and brought up the idea, hey, why don't we take a vacation on Venus? Why don't we vacation on Venus? I mean, people are going vacationing all the time, and I never go on a vacation. I always feel like, almost never. I always feel like, you know, someday I'm going to have a really big vacation. And it's come up now, hey, why not go take a vacation on Venus while the world has its temper tantrum? Like I said, students taking over a university and shutting everything down for a while. Maybe this world's going to, there are those who want to just shut this place down for a while and have their temper tantrum and pretend that, you know, that they're big shots and don't need any therapy, don't need any spiritual practice. Well, why not just let them go ahead and burn out their, you know, whatever it is, get it out of their system so until they collapse and say, you know what, let's start over and let's really build momentum now this time. Let's just take a vacation, then come back and help out if that's called for. So this idea is percolating and saying, yeah, why not? Why not take a vacation? Go to Venus for a vacation. People go all over this world for vacations, don't they? Someone hops on a plane, let's go to Hawaii. Well, I mean, it wasn't long ago that the idea of let's just go to Hawaii was like incredibly difficult. Well, you'd have, you know, you'd take a steamer there, you know, before air travel, and before there was a steamer, you couldn't get to Hawaii really, unless you were had some reed raft from the South Sea Islands or something. But it was pretty isolated, wasn't it? So advancements in transportation allowed us to eventually go to Hawaii, and people now jump on a plane and go to Hawaii, which I haven't been to since 1975, I think. 1975, I've been to Hawaii. I thought I'd be going there all the time. No. But the idea is, it's out in this ocean, like space. Space is like an ocean. How do we traverse the ocean of space? Well, advances in transportation certainly would takes care of that. But we don't have that kind of transportation here on this planet yet. Okay, fine. But the Venusians do. Most certainly they do. They visited this Earth with various transportation devices. Okay, so I was thinking, like, hey, Jesus invited me, said, to his home, say, would you like to see my home? Would you like to visit my home? Would you like to visit my home? That's what he said. Would you like to visit my home? And I said, yeah, absolutely. Then I was thinking, how do I get to his home? And then he said, it's right around the corner. Just the second house on the left there. I go around the corner, it's just the corner house, then there's the next house. You know, it's that one. Interesting. Could be referring to the moon as one planet you would pass, perhaps on the way to Venus, and then Venus. Yeah. Because the corner house is on both streets, so the moon belongs to both Earth and space, right? So you go past the moon, and then you get to Venus. So Venus would be like the second house there. If you're going towards the sun, we would think of going to the left, so to speak, going in towards the sun. If you were, yeah, that's how I would look at it. And I looked, it was a white house, very reflective white house. Well, Venus is this bright star. It's bright because the albedo of the clouds of Venus, the constellation of the clouds and the crystalline acids of gaseous acids or something in the clouds reflect light. It's very, very reflective. That's why it's so bright. It's a bright morning star. Some people say the star of Bethlehem. Some people say Jesus came from Venus, as a matter of fact. So I'm thinking, hey, maybe would you like to visit my home? Maybe the same, would you like to visit Venus? You know, if you would have said that, I said, what? But thinking about it, that's not very far out. For me, it's not that far out at all. We can hop on a plane right now and go visit South Africa. Go visit Japan, you know, just fly over oceans and continents, and phew, there we are. And we think, well, that's no big deal. Well, why should it be such a big deal if there's appropriate transport, just like a plane takes us, like, you know, we go halfway around the world, it might take us 20 hours to get there. If we have appropriate transportation, we could just, maybe it takes us 20 hours or less to go fly to Venus. Visit Venus. Why shouldn't we visit it? Why shouldn't we visit the other areas in our solar system? Just like, why shouldn't we visit the other, you know, continents in this world? People didn't used to do that so much, but now people think nothing of visiting everywhere in this world. Except I don't. I really don't have any desire to do that. But going to Venus, yeah. I would enjoy that, actually. They have flying cars there. They don't have the wheel there. What we're told is that development of the wheel is a really regressive thing. That's what set this world back so badly, is development of the wheel. That advanced societies don't use the wheel. That actually sets back your transportation mode, and the whole way you think is changed. So they don't even use the wheel. They don't have cars that go along roads. They have cars that fly through space, flying cars. Uh, So that would be fun to fly, maybe take a tour around Venus, fourth dimensional tour, or I don't know how the vibrational matchup would happen, but there's probably some way to deal with that. It's between third dimensional and the etheric realm. You know, there's probably some way that could happen. And why would I be invited to Jesus' home unless there was a way to get there and it was doable? So I just have to take Jesus at his word. He said, would you like to visit my home? There must be a way. I said, there must be a way. There must be a way. It's not some cruel joke. You're not going to ask someone to come to your home and they can't do it. They say, if someone says, come to visit me in Hawaii, you know, there must be a way to get there. Sure, there's a plane. Okay, I'll come visit you in Hawaii. So I'm just saying, okay, there must be a way. But, you know, not from this world. I don't see how, you know. So there must be some way, some, you know, I imagine as I just thinking, okay, maybe Jesus has a transport vehicle, right? Why not? Right? Don't people in this world, people have private jets? Don't the big wigs in this world have private jets, private transport? Don't, like, sports teams charter airplanes? They have their own airplane. They charter, some own their own airplane, right? So I would think that Jesus would have his own, you know, transport, maybe company, a whole fleet, a transport fleet. I would think so. If he's inviting us, if he's here in this world inviting us to visit his home, he must have a fleet. You would think so. Otherwise, why extend the invitation? You see, why extend the invitation if you have no means to get there? And he said, don't worry about the means. When he left this world 2,000 years ago, he said, I'll come back for you and take you to my dwelling place, and don't worry about where it is or the means to get there. You will know. When the time comes, you will know. Okay? So, back then, people didn't understand about the planets so much, and, you know, traveling to other planets and spaceships. And they didn't understand that stuff, but now we certainly do. We certainly have sent, you know, rovers. One's a rover on Mars right now, I believe. And there's satellites, not satellites, but rovers and various missions checking out Jupiter, checking out, you know, all the planets, pretty much so. So we certainly understand that, you know, it's possible to go to those places. So I was thinking today, I said, you know what, why don't I just ask Jesus to send me a limo? Kind of joking, though. Jesus, send me a limousine. Pick me up in a limo and take me to Venus. Why not? I could use a vacation, actually. Could really use a vacation. I could use a vacation from this world. You know, this world is just, you know. And again, of course, if you were off this planet, well, I'm sure the Venusians know what's going on this planet. If you wanted to check in what's going on this planet, they probably have a news feed there, you know, to tell you what's going on this planet. But it's not like we really need to know what's going on here. We know what's going on here, actually. Same old, only more so. I guess when you come back from vacation on Venus, like you come back in the world, it's like become just a really, really, really nasty place. Well, sure. What do you expect? It's already that way. And it's a place where we've lost our spiritual momentum. A lot of momentum has been lost and fragmented, and people have been compromised, and they just don't have, and that decay could set in quickly and collapse. Like, you have some fruit or vegetable in your refrigerator where you leave it too long, and at some point the bacteria, something starts growing in there, right? And then very quickly, boom, you know, it's gone. When fruit starts to go, it can go in a hurry. Well, when this world starts to go, it can go in a hurry, actually. September 9/11 is coming up. The 13th anniversary of 9/11 is coming up. And, you know, things are getting rather dicey, actually, in this world. Very dicey. And I think everybody's got the jitters in one way or the other, and probably rightfully so. So, you know, it might be a really nice time to take a Venusian vacation. Take a Venusian vacation. Why not? See the sights. Get meet your neighbors. You know, well, isn't it time we meet our neighbors? Isn't it time we meet our neighbors? Introduce yourself. Hi. You know, hi, I'm Clarity Ross from planet Earth. Actually, I'm not from any world at all. There are no worlds. There isn't any form anywhere. But you can, you know, just for the sake of conversation, you'll say, I happen to be being aware of this appearance that we call planet Earth. So hey, howdy neighbor, and I'd love to see the appearances that you have, that you're manifesting here. Maybe there'll be some press conference there. I'd like to introduce the group that has come to Venus, to vacation on Venus from planet Earth. It's been a long time since we've had anyone from Earth visiting here and, you know, answer questions at press conference and take the grand tour of Venus. Why not? If it was available to us, why not? Yeah, a great excuse to get out of this planet for a while. The stuff here is getting it's get the feeling like it's trending in a very weird direction, this world, and we all know that. So I just said, hey Jesus, send me a limo, pick me up, send me a limo. If you want me to come, you know, send me a limo. That's not an unreasonable request. I'm not gonna just sit here and say, how do I get there? Well, just ask the one who had sent the invitation and say, okay, fine, I'm ready to go. You send a limousine and bring me to Venus and let's tour Venus and meet and greet with Venusians. Fourth dimensional Venusians, there's a vibrational difference. Now, Venusians are able to come here to this world, so I would assume we'd be able to go there. You know, I would assume so. They look very much like us, actually. Very much like us. There's hardly very little difference, actually. So it's not like, you know, it's a weird freak out situation at all. So just sort of brainstorming this whole situation, because I always ask, what am I supposed to do here? What am I supposed to do here in this world? I always ask that question. I never get an answer. Never get an answer. And I say, that is really weird. I mean, I say, I've got to live here. I've got to, you know, so what can I do? How can I earn a living here? What is this? Holy Spirit never gives an answer. And I've always been very upset about that. Well, what if I wasn't here? What if I wasn't living here for a while? I wouldn't need to be earning a living here if I didn't live here. Maybe I'm living on Venus for a while. Until all this storm blows over. You know, when there's a severe storm, like Katrina comes in New Orleans, they say, hey, get out of New Orleans, go somewhere else, out of the path of this hurricane. And the people who did were fortunate ones. The ones who stayed were not so fortunate, were they? So there's a time to get out of Dodge, and sometimes you have to be a refugee. And if you can have Jesus send you a limo, pick you up and take you to Venus, say let's tour Venus as a group. We'll take a whole group and we'll tour Venus. Jesus will show us the sights of Venus and the way of life they're living there, etc. Why not do it? Why not do it? Get out of the way of the storm. In this world, get out of the way of the storm. Most people say, oh, that's too extreme, you know. No, we'll just hunker down. That's like people in New Orleans say, nah, they always say that the storm's going to be bad, but never is. We'll just stay here and hunker down. Everything will be fine. Guess what? It wasn't fine. So we're tending to have a lot of bad case scenarios unfold in this world. Very bad case scenarios. And 9/11 started it, you know. That was like a worst case scenario. Who would ever thought those towers would actually fall, especially World Tower number 7, which wasn't even a hit. And then we had the Boxing Day tsunami, then we had the Fukushima tsunami. We had the Gulf oil spill, being a bizarre worst case scenario. So we're in a situation, we tend to be having worst case scenarios. Well, maybe that will continue with the world. Maybe the world will have a worst case scenario. Just say, hey neighbor, could you lend a helping hand here? We've got troubles here right now. You know, the Mississippi is flooding. You know, can I go? Would you mind if I, you know, stayed at your place for a while? Might take a while to rebuild here. You know, there's a big flood here. And talk to your neighbors. Talk to your neighbors. Who's our neighbors? Mars is our neighbors. Venus, Mercury is our neighbors. So why not say, hey Venus, how about, can I get a hand? Can I get some help from you? Maybe they're just waiting to be asked. You know, maybe they say, sure. We know the flood is coming. We know this problem is coming. So, but we can't force it upon you. We can't force you to, you know, to come here. But if you just ask, we'll say, sure, absolutely. We're all set up for it. We prepared. We saw it. We've seen it coming. So we were hoping that you might think that way. Think outside the box. I mean, we're so caught up in this box that, you know, we're a body in a world. We're not. We're spirit. We're free. There is no world. There is no form. There is no time, space, form, process, duration, location. Not really at all. They're not really. But certainly, we should not have to keep thinking that somehow we're isolated. We're isolated. You know, maybe that's through our own blinders that we think we're isolated. So I would enjoy visiting Venus. There's really no place in this world I really particularly want to visit. Coachella Valley is the only place I really like going to, really. I don't know if it says reminds me of Venus. May have been there in the past, that's possible. But it certainly gives me this feeling like, wow, there's a better place somewhere. So like this memory, maybe it's a dream memory. It's like, you know, I went there in spirit. I feel like, I know there's a better place. And this reminds me of this better place. It's just so softly serene and beautiful and peaceful and harmonious. Wow. But I have been able to get back to Coachella Valley recently. I wanted to and just can't do it. Don't have the funds to do it. And that's really disturbing. I say, what's going on? Well, maybe there's something better. That's what the Holy Spirit says. Well, what if there's something even better than the Coachella Valley? I said, wow, I don't know where that would be in the world. Well, maybe it's not this world. See, maybe it's not this world. Maybe it's Venus, and those who have reported about Venus, and those who have come here from Venus, explain it to us, and, you know, it is better in this world, for sure. The fourth dimensional Venus, the third, appears like a desert, feels very dry, and cloudy, and, you know, the pressure is severe there. It's not really habitable, except you'd have to have a biosphere or something, you would think. But fourth dimensional Venus is really quite beautiful. So it's time to think outside the box and stop this isolationist mindset we have here, that we have to solve all our problems ourselves. Why do we have to solve all our problems ourselves? What do you mean ourselves? Aren't we all one self? Well, then let's turn to our one self that is everywhere. And pragmatically, let's turn to what the one self that is near to us, near, which would be Venus, and say, hey, Venus, okay. Well, it's a go. Let's press go on this mission. Maybe there's a big mission for Exodus. Maybe then the next big exodus is out of this world to Venus or other planets, actually. Maybe there's various places on different planets. Maybe on Mars, maybe on Mercury, you know, other dimensions. There may be quite a number of dwelling places, actually, in the solar system that we could actually go to, you know, temporarily get off this Earth. As Earth goes through some catastrophe, which is supposedly going to happen, there's supposedly some worst-case scenarios likely to happen here. And but I say that the loss of spiritual momentum is the worst catastrophe of all, and that's already happened. And we certainly don't want to get sucked down by that. You know, it's like this black hole seems to be operating here. So for me, it's like it's worth the attention for me, the time and attention to say, hey, okay, will it happen or not? I don't know. But attention-wise, it's worth it to me to start paying some attention to this and say, you know, yeah, let me then make a prayer in Jesus' name for Jesus' limo. Send your personal limousine here, which means, you know, his fleet, his transport capability. Send it here to Earth, pick me up, and I'll go. And see where that goes. See how this attention shift, see what happens with this attention shift. Because I certainly don't see anything in this world that is developing in a positive way. I really don't. And I can't, my prayers don't give me any sense of positivity here in the future of this planet right now. No sense of that. It's just the momentum isn't there. So it may be time to shift and find maybe the thread of our momentum, the flow of our momentum might be flowing to Venus, actually. It may be, and from Venus it may flow to other dwelling places, actually, because they have the capability to travel throughout the universe, actually. And we may go into the flow of being cosmic citizens at this point. It may be the time to become cosmic citizens. I know everybody, it seems like so many people, not everybody, but so many people on this planet are waiting for the ETs to come here, the ETs to land, and I say, hello, and, you know, and we're here on Earth, and we're going to help you do this, blah, blah, blah. But not too many people are expecting us to go to Venus, to leave this planet to other dwelling places, and from there to branch out and become cosmic citizens, capability to travel anywhere through thought, and eventually, you know, end up in the paradise realm, and eventually totally evaporate our continuity fear completely and recognize that we are formless, we're spirit. That's just not talked about. We're just waiting for the saucer to land on the White House lawn and says, you know what, we figured out a way to help you out here with some, you know, some medicines here and some energy, blah, blah, blah. I'd say thinking outside the box is Jesus sends his limousine here and says, hop in, free ride, no charge. Takes you to Venus. Says, hang out here for a while. Got some really nice parks, golf courses, extraordinarily beautiful place, peaceful people. Be able to do a tremendous amount of contemplation, meditation. There's a lot of spiritual teaching going here, a lot of spiritual momentum here. You'll be able to, you know, get into that. Your progress may just be, you know, astronomical, so to speak. Yeah, why not? Why isn't there more thought in that direction? There's, I don't know, really any like that. But I'm sure putting my attention there right now. It just doesn't seem to be any place else to put it in this world that merits it. It just doesn't seem to be anything that is like, seem to be very, you know, fortuitous momentum in this world that something's real. Just doesn't seem to be that way. I can't find it. So, I'm going to see how shifting my attention in that direction, see what kind of fruit that bears. Maybe try to see if I can visit Venus in my, you know, astral body, dream body, as it were, and just go to Venus and say, hey, you know, I feel like, can I bring my body here? Can I leave planet Earth for a while, take a vacation here, stay here for a while? It's like an evacuee situation where you may be staying there for, you know, several years or something. It's possible eventually, but I could take a short vacation. Why not go for a couple weeks to Venus? Again, transport is not much different than going to Hawaii, actually. Go to Hawaii for a couple weeks, come back. Not that you might want to come back, but you might get homesick for sure. I miss the negativity, probably. You miss the negativity. Wow, where's that negativity? Oh, planet Earth. Oh, that's, yeah, I got it there. So, you know, is this right or is this wrong? Who knows? The world is, of course, telling me you've got it wrong. I feel the pressure. Like, oh, you've got it wrong. You must have it wrong. Basically, thinking that we have to solve our own problems. What is this nonsense? We have to solve our own problems. What problems, actually? The fact is we don't have any problems, except the continuity problem. And who says we have to solve the continuity problem without any help? The Holy Spirit and those who have no continuity fear are helping us with this. God helps us with our continuity problem. So it's all in play. The entire universe and more is totally in play as far as helping us resolve our continuity problem. No effort is spared to help us on with this. None. So keep this in mind. When you accept that the continuity problem is your only problem, you don't have any other problem, then you are literally accepting the fact that you can be helped in any way, which way, any which way. The entire grace of God in all ways is there to help out with this continuity problem and maintain the momentum, which is so important. So anything is in play. Going to Venus is entirely in play. Anything and everything is in play. Jesus said, would you like to visit my home? I said, wow. Well, yeah, but where? Oh, yeah, sure, well, okay, but now where is it? I thought it'd be far away. No, he says, very close. Very, very close. In other words, he gave me the impression, it's no problem to get there. That's the clear-cut communication that I received, that it's no problem at all. It's very close. You won't have any problem getting there. So I just say, okay, take him at his word. Won't have any problem getting there. So, okay, let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Let's get the ball rolling and find out. There may be a huge exodus from planet Earth actually coming up. And there may need to be some pioneers who need to go first and scope it out and come back and tell people, okay, yes, everything's fine. It's all set up for you. It's not, no worries, no worries. Like that. And I come from a pioneering family. My ancestors were some very notable explorers that were the first people to go to places and discover these places, actually. So I come from a tradition of those who explore and go to places other people haven't gone, or very few have gone. So that's certainly something I'm very comfortable with. If I were to go to Venus and people would say, wow, and greet you like, hey, we don't have many Earth people coming here. I say, yeah, they're not really thinking all in that direction, but once something is discovered, explored, and there's a way and stuff, then people start saying, hey, you know what, I'd like to go too. It's just breaking the ice that's the hard part. Breaking the ice is the hard part. Nobody wants to go first. You know, it's like, wow, what's there? I don't know. But I was brought up with stories of exploration. This is just totally something that's for me. He said, yeah, I'd love to go. I'll do it. And shouldn't be a problem. No, Jesus is there. It's not a problem. I'm sure if Jesus says, this is my guest here in Venus, you know, just imagine how you're going to be treated. So, we'll see how this goes. We'll see how this goes. I don't know. But it's at least worth to have some attention on this, thinking, is this possible? Because something needs to be possible in this world going forward, right? You get this feeling like things are not trending in the right direction, and people are nervous and jittery for a very good reason. So it's good to have some options available. Good to have some options available, right? So let's explore. I'm going to explore this option and see what comes of it. Already there's been quite a bit of feedback and positivity about this. You know, pretty amazing. Pretty amazing. I wouldn't be surprised if it was true. Would not be surprised. So, anyway, I hope this was an interesting video, certainly. It was a different style than what you're used to hearing, isn't it? Okay. All right. Very great. That's it.